All right, so in this video, let's go ahead and break down what a landing page in the home services niche looks like. And we're gonna go straight into it. If you run any types of home services, whether it's plumbing, whether it's electricians, whether it's pest control, or you can even use these landing pages for Medicare, for health insurance, auto insurance, whatever you want, this is essentially how you do it. So let's go ahead and start. Everything on this landing page essentially leads into a phone call because phone calls convert the best for ultimately the business because they're talking to somebody and they get them on the phone and they go through the process of the sale, they go through the process of closing the deal, et cetera, et cetera. So let's go ahead and break down our landing page. At the top here, we have our main keyword. We're targeting locksmiths. And then right below that, we have the city. Now, the city itself is dynamically populated. So right now we're on the URL of California/Los Angeles. But if we type in, for example, Michigan, Chicago, that gets changed to Michigan, Chicago. If we continue down, we have here as of March 24th, 4:56 p.m. So wherever the person is visiting from, it will show their time zone, right? It will show the time that they're in. Obviously, every single country or zone in the world has a different representation of how they show time. So in the settings of something I will show you later, you can actually adjust the output of this. So this would actually be outputted as 16:57, depending on which part of the world you're in. The next up is we have the call button. So everything on this page basically leads into a phone call. We are running this as a mobile landing page. We're only targeting mobile traffic because we only want the person to make a phone call. Everything has to lead into a phone call. So I'll right click here and inspect. And this is what our landing page looks like in phone call format. So some things get adjusted here. I have to adjust, but for the most part, you continue down and it goes into mobile format. Let's go back into our desktop format for now. Okay, so the next thing that we have down here are our trust badges. Now you saw there's a little bit of modification there. I have to fix that, but not a big deal. Down here, we have the image. This image is AI generated. If you look a little bit closer to this part, it's a little bit off, it's a little bit strange, but no one really pays attention, no one notices. This is as real as it gets, and this was absolutely free to generate. We continue down. Down here, we have once again our location insertion. So in this case, the person is in Chicago, Michigan, right? Because we typed in Chicago, Michigan. But let's go up here once more, and let's say we don't know what the location is that the person's visiting from. So we'll just take that out completely, and we'll just go to the main locksmith page. Now, what you see is my location. So I'm located in Buenos Aires, Argentina. And whatever location that you're visiting from, it will show this address. It will show this location that you're visiting from. So you continue down, Buenos Aires, and all of a sudden we have locksmiths serving Buenos Aires. So whatever city that the person is coming from, it will show their city, right? Pretty cool. Now let's go ahead and keep moving downwards. Down here, we have areas serviced. So whatever the location, once more, that the person is visiting from, they will see a map, and this kind of guides them into assuming that your service reaches this radius of 20 kilometers, and it makes it a little bit more personalized. But let's go ahead and go back to our URL here, and we'll do, for example, New York, and then dash New York. Right? So once again, our landing page, it shows that we serve New York, New York. We'll go down, locksmiths in New York, New York, and boom, the map is populated based on the URL that you put here. But let's say that maybe you're trying to serve a city that is currently not supported by my system. Let's go ahead up here and type in location equals, let's say, for example, Delhi, India. And hey, look at that. We have locksmiths in Delhi, India. Incredible, right? So 24/7 locksmiths in Delhi, India. Locksmiths, Delhi, India. Oh, and guess what? The map also gets populated to Delhi, India. We can even just change it once more. I don't know. We'll do, for example, Vancouver, Canada, just to really push the point here. So Vancouver, Canada. and Vancouver, Canada, and Vancouver, Canada. Or you could just do the province. So Canada has provinces, Vancouver, Ontario, and yeah, well, in this case, it looks like it didn't get it properly. Maybe we'll try a ON. Oh, right, because we don't have a Ontario, it's not in Ontario. It would be in BC, British Columbia. All right, so there we go, BC and Vancouver, British Columbia. So what this means is that you have three different ways of getting the person's location. Number one is you simply type it in into the URL up here. And for SEO purposes, this is an actual page. This is an actual page for Google, right? As well as California, San Francisco, you can push these into Google search SEO and each one is an actual page. Number two is you simply type in the location here. So location equals whatever, comma, whatever. So we're just literally pushing the location in there and it goes like that. Or number three, no location is inputted and it just detects where the person is coming from, right? So they could be coming from Mendoza, Argentina. They could be coming from Kochi, India. They could be coming from Berlin, Germany. It doesn't matter. It will literally show their location unless you define it at the top here. And then once again, we continue down. Everything once again leads to a phone call. And down here, once again, the location gets populated. And you have a couple of trust badges here, disclaimers, et cetera, et cetera. So let's go ahead and inspect what all this stuff as it looks like on a mobile device. And we can do once more. What do we have here? California, Los Angeles, and then boom, right? So this is what the person will see when they land on your landing page. Now, let's say you're running this landing page through Google Ads, which you probably are, and you want to add the actual keyword that the person is typing into Google, or at least the keywords that you're bidding on into the landing page. So here what we'll do is we'll go to our URL bar, and then the actual keyword here is dynamic. So it's based on what we put in. So locksmith in this case is the default, right? But let's say we want to change it to something completely different. So we'll do 24/7 door unlock. And then boom, 24/7 door unlock hotline in San Francisco, California, right? And then obviously it gets associated with whatever state we want. So instead of San Francisco, we can do Fresno. There you go. So door unlock, that's the keyword, and then the dynamic location, right? So these are on the landing page. So this is our landing page, but these little dynamic sections are things you can use on any page anywhere on your site, right? You can use it in your WooCommerce shopping. You can use it on your pay-per-call landing page. You can use it on your sales page, however you want, right? So the more personalized the landing page is to the person who's visiting, the more likely it is to convert. One final thing. Let's say you're visiting my landing page and for whatever reason, it's listing your city as being something completely different or even 20 kilometers away. So you're running Google Ads to your landing page. They get on your landing page and it's showing a city that's kind of far away. So what do? We can get Google to pass their location number to us. So every single location in the world has a Google location number associated with it. We take that number that Google appends to our landing page, to our URL, and that number gets translated into a location. This number here represents Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and this is a number that we would get directly from Google Ads. Once again, we have another number here. This number here represents Fargo, North Dakota, and finally we have this number here represents whatever this is. So Google Ads will literally give us the location of the person so it is as accurate as possible. Because in this case, the geolocation IP might not be completely accurate, but the number that Google gives us is almost as accurate as just getting the data from the person on the phone call. So we're getting as close as possible to getting the exact location from the person as possible because Google is giving it to us. So all of these things that I just showed you are happening on the back end using a plugin that I developed. Right now it's called the PPC Basic plugin. I will show you and explain to you a little bit more detail in another video. One thing you can definitely do is call this number on here that dynamically changes every single time, right? So every single time is gonna have a different phone number depending on who's visiting or what city you're visiting from, et cetera, et cetera. And when you call that number, you actually will get a coupon code that you can use for the plugin that will have future tutorials as well. So number one, you're gonna get essentially 10 days free trial. So use the plugin for yourself for 10 days, no hassles. And if you use the coupon code, you will also get 30% off. So go ahead and call the number, get the coupon code, test out this plugin for 10 days, and also check out the videos that I'll be appending to this whole thing as well. Leonidas here, and I will see you in the next video.